Welcome to Super Kid Academy, a place where ordinary kids do extraordinary things through the power of God's Word. We meet every Sunday morning at 9 a.m. for Sunday school, and our main service begins at 10 a.m. We also have Wednesday night programming that starts at 7 p.m. where our students receive hands-on training and experience. They do arts and crafts, learn how to operate cameras, sing, cook, prepare and write sermons, and many more exciting things. Make sure to come and visit Super Kid Academy.
Wow, what a beautiful day at the park. Oh, I just love the trees and the butterflies. Oh, and the beautiful clouds. It's so relaxing and peaceful and quiet.
Johnny, I told you, we need to get out here with some vitamin D. You've been playing too many video games all day, Johnny.
But I like video games. Oh my goodness! That's Miss Grace! Miss Grace!
Hi, Johnny! Hi!
Miss Grace! Miss Grace, I thought you lived at the school!
Okay, bye. Hi.
Okay. All right, everybody stay over there, because I want to go talk to Miss Grace. Miss Grace.
Hi, Johnny.
Hey, Miss Grace.
So good to see you.
I thought you lived at the school. I didn't think that you were coming out here and that I'd see you at the park and stuff. How you doing? I bet you miss all them kids.
I do. I really miss the kids. I'm enjoying my summer break, though, and the peace and quiet. But I will be so excited to return to school in the fall.
I bet you will. You are my favorite teacher.
Oh, thank you,
Johnny. You so help me with math. I don't know what it is about math. Sometimes I count, and then I run out of fingers. And then I got to think about it, and my brain cramps up.
Yeah.
But you help take all the cramps out of my brain and help me so much with math. I just love you.
Oh, I love you too, Johnny. I'm so glad I was able to help you with math. So what brings you out to the park today?
Well, you know, I just kind of wanted to come out here and hang out. Mama said I had to get out of the house because she said I played too many video games. I need some exercise. I ate a whole lot of Fruit Loops. Miss Grace,
Fruit Loops.
I had a big old bowl of Fruit Loops.
Wow.
And I ate it with a big spoon like this. And then I had to, Mama said I got to get outside and get on a jungle gym or something to get rid of them Fruit Loops.
Well, what kind of games do you like to play at the park?
I like to play all kinds of games. I like to play on the slide. I like to play tag. I like to play hide and seek. I am real good at hide and seek.
Wow.
Can't nobody find me. And then when I count real fast so I can see where everybody's going. I count like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm ready.
That's so fast.
And then I see people run, but nobody ever find me. Nobody.
Okay. Well, would you like to play a game now?
Yeah, I want to play a game.
Yeah.
What game you want to play? You want to play hide and seek?
How about I Spy?
I Spy?
Yeah.
Somebody
spies an object, and then you search for it, and you try to find it.
Oh, my brain.
Oh, it's not that hard, Johnny.
Because you're asking me to think. Hold on a second.
That's okay.
Okay,
I can help you.
Okay,
if you need help, I can help you.
Now, see, when you help me, all the cramps go away.
Okay. Okay, well, why don't you start, Johnny?
Okay, I'm going to start?
Yeah, you start.
All right. I'm supposed to pick something, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes, you find something to spy.
Oh, okay.
And then I'll find it.
And you gonna find it?
Yes. So you could tell me what color it is.
You ain't gonna ever find what I pick.
Okay.
I'm gonna pick something real hard.
Okay, if it's hard, can you help me?
I'm gonna try.
Okay.
But I'm gonna pick something real hard.
Okay.
I spy something green.
Something green.
She ain't gonna ever find it.
We are in a park.
You ain't gonna ever find it.
I know. It's the green grass all around us.
Oh, wow, you know it. You already found it.
It was a good one, Johnny. That was a really good try.
Was that a good one?
That was a great job. High five.
High five.
Good job.
High five.
Okay, Johnny. I spy something blue.
You spy something blue. Let me see.
I spy something blue.
No, I can't find nothing blue.
Nothing blue?
Nothing blue.
Do you need some help?
I need help.
Could somebody help Johnny find something blue? Raise your hand. Cadet Piper, do you see anything blue maybe by your feet.
Could that,
that
you gonna help me?
Come here.
The ball.
The ball.
Is that blue?
It's blue.
I knew that, but I thought you meant a different shade of blue.
Oh, that's okay.
Like,
that's okay.
Indigo.
That's okay. You know, everyone needs help sometimes. It's okay to ask for help, Johnny.
I hate asking for help. Sometimes when I ask for help, I feel like I can't get it right on my own, and it makes me feel real bad. I don't like asking for help.
Well, you know, Johnny, everyone needs help sometimes.
Really?
Really.
Like, you need help? You don't ever need help. You help me. You don't ever need help, Miss Grace, because you're smart.
Well, actually, Johnny, sometimes I need help, too.
Really?
Really. You know, everyone has hard choices sometimes. Everyone's made mistakes sometimes, and we've all needed help to get out of it.
Well, who helps us? Like, I know my mama sometimes tries to help me. I don't want my mama to help me. And then you help me, and I kind of like it when you help me, but
yeah.
I don't want anybody else to help me. Who is there that can help us when we make mistakes?
Well, Johnny, God sent his only son named Jesus to die on the cross for our sins because he knew that we would all need help.
Now, hang on a second. Grandmama told me a story about a man named Jesus in a book called the Bible.
That's right.
And she said that Jesus walked on water, which makes Jesus pretty cool.
He's pretty
and
cool.
And she said Jesus healed some people like a blind man. That's pretty cool too.
That is really cool.
And I don't know if there's a hide and seek story in the Bible about Jesus, but I bet if he played hide and seek, he'd be real good.
Well, you know, it does say that Jesus came to seek and save the lost. So that's kind of like hide and seek, right?
I mean, yeah, I suppose so. Because if you're playing hide and seek, you're kind of lost.
Right. Do you know what happens when we ask him for help? What? When we're lost and we need to be found by Jesus and he becomes our savior, he cleanses us from all of our sin and he makes us a new person.
A brand new person?
Brand new.
Oh, my. How do I ask Jesus for help, though? I've got his phone number. I can't text him. I'm sure he don't play video games, so I couldn't talk to him on a video game.
Well, Matthew 7:7 says, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you.
Well, I can seek because I play hide and seek. And
yeah,
I can
you
knock,
can.
Sometimes I knock on the door.
Mm-hmm.
But how do I ask?
All you have to do, it's really simple, is you just repeat and say a prayer, and Jesus hears you, and he'll become your savior.
Really?
Really, it's that simple.
Can
you
I
know,
do that?
You know how I taught you about your multiplication problems?
Oh, my brain's cramping again. They're gonna talk about math. Hold on a second. I got 10 toes. And 5 fingers. No, I got 10 fingers.
Okay.
I got 10 fingers. And 10. Okay.
Well, remember how it seemed really hard at first?
Yes.
And then we made it really simple.
And then we made it simple.
It can seem hard at first to talk to Jesus, but it's actually really simple. All you have to do is just say a prayer.
All I got to do is say a prayer?
All you got to do. And you can repeat after me if you want.
I want to repeat after you, but hang on a second, because
okay.
I got this ball, and you told me this ball's blue. Isn't that blue?
It is blue.
All right, hang on a second. Hey, can you hold my ball for a second? I'm about to say a prayer. Are you going to say a prayer, too? You're not going to say the prayer? All right, I'm going to go say the prayer. Can you just hold it? I'm going to come back to the ball.
All right, Johnny.
All right, I was ready.
All right, okay, repeat after me. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
I believe. You are the Son of God.
You are the Son of God.
That you died. And you rose again. I need your help in my life.
I need your help in my life.
Forgive me of all my sin. Be my Lord and Savior. And my best friend. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Woohoo! I feel so good.
Oh,
this
yes,
so
Johnny.
Cool. I'm so excited. I'm going to tell everybody that I said this prayer and I got
yeah.
some help because I need help sometimes.
Absolutely.
And I'm so excited about this. This is
I'm so
wonderful.
Glad Jesus came to give us new life. So that's the life of God that you're feeling right now.
Is it
now.
Really? Because I like this life. I bet
it
I can
is.
Beat anybody in hide and seek.
And
right
now
you
that
you want to play hide and seek, I bet I can beat you. You want to play hide and seek? I bet I can beat you. Who thinks they can beat me in hide and seek? You can't beat me in hide and seek now that I got Jesus.
Well, Johnny, now that you have Jesus and all this energy, would you like to play a game?
Yes, I want to play a game. Want to play hide and seek?
How about tag?
Tag?
Yeah.
I don't know about playing tag.
Oh!
I was going down, thought it was for the count. Then I found your love. I had wandered off, thought I had gone too far. There I found your love. Fear I used to know can't stop me anymore, 'cause I found your love. When I feel alone, I have a place to go, 'cause I found your love. Great was the dead of sin, grace brought me back.
Out there, way to go. That's what we do in Super Kid Academy when the commanders or lieutenant commanders come out, or captains. We just honor and we stand at attention like they do in the military, because do you know that we're in the army of the Lord? Do you realize that you're part of God's army? Praise God. Well, today we're going to talk about I spy love. Say, I spy love. Now, have y'all ever done and doodled in one of these I spy books? No. No? Y'all, I grew up on these.
Yes.
I was born in the 80s. These were like the thing. So what's really cool about, well, it's kind of challenging, really. All right, so right here, this is Detective Donald. You see Donald, say hi, Donald.
Hi, Donald.
He's a detective. Now it tells me, whenever I go to this page, it tells me to find Donald, okay? Now Donald is wearing a green hat and a yellow coat. And as you can see on this page, there's a lot of green and yellow, right? It's kind of hard to see. There's a lot of different objects. So it's hard to spot Donald really, really easily. And even on some of the things where I see Donald at, his jacket isn't even really, really bright yellow. But just because I can't see Donald right away, does that mean Donald's not there? No, Donald is absolutely in these pages. And you know, this kind of is like our life. Whenever we open the pages of our life, and maybe there's a lot going on, maybe there's some issue, you know, some challenges with friends at school. Maybe there's some challenges with your family. Maybe something sad might have just happened. Or maybe there's just a lot of noise, there's a lot of video games, and you just can't get quiet. And that's kind of how life is sometimes. There's a lot going on. But in the midst of everything, God's love and God's goodness is on every page of your life. Say, God's love.
God's love.
God's goodness.
God's goodness
is on every page of my life. But sometimes what we got to do, Super Kids, is we got to take our magnifying glasses and we got to spy out and get a little bit closer. Oh, I see Detective Donald. There he is. Oh, there he is again. Now I can see him because I have my magnifying glass. And this is a lot like the Holy Spirit in our lives. Whenever we receive Jesus as our Lord and our Savior, the Holy Spirit comes to live on the inside of us to be our helper. And one of the roles of the Holy Spirit, it says the Holy Spirit will show us things to come. Isn't that cool to have a friend that helps you see a lot of things that you can't always see?
Yeah.
Yeah? Well, that's what the Holy Spirit does for you. So the Holy Spirit, among all of the stuff, the Holy Spirit will highlight his love and his goodness that he has for you. Now, what we do, I spy books are just for fun, but where do we go to find God's love? To the Bible, right? Did any of y'all bring your Bibles? I know sometimes you don't always bring your Bibles to Super. You brought your Bible. Way to go. Way to go, Super. Go. Way to go, Remington. Way to go, Joy. All right. So what we're going to do is I'm going to open up the Word of God, and I'm going to find God's love for me in this Bible. Now, this Bible, y'all, it's really big. It's kind of big, right? How many of y'all like to read? Oh, good. Readers are leaders. That's very good. I have to admit, I'm not a big reader, okay? I have a hard time reading, like, a lot of books. I love reading my Bible. I read my Bible every day. But I'm not really into, like, reading these large books. And sometimes it could feel a little overwhelming because there's so many pages and there's so many words. And you may feel like, but God, how can I find your love in all of this? But what are we gonna do? We're going to pull out our magnifying glasses. We're going to ask the Holy Spirit to highlight his love. And as you keep on going down these pages, I see some red letters. What does that mean when you see red letters in the Bible? That's Jesus talking. Oh, man, this has got to be good. I got to find this love here. What is that? John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. So you mean, Commander Jennifer, that God had only one son, say one son. He loved his son very, very much. Jesus was with him at the very beginning of time. It says that Jesus was part of creation. But he looked down and he saw all of us. And he said, you know what? Like what Miss Grace taught little Johnny today. We all need help. How many of y'all have ever needed help in your life? We all have needed help. And God looked down, he's like, took his magnifying, he's like, oh man, they need a lot of help. I gotta send my son. And what he did, he sent his son to die on the cross for me and for you. Why? Because we needed help. Because we've all made mistakes. Because we've all lied. Commander Jennifer, you've lied. I have lied before. It's not good, but I have. And whenever you make a mistake, and if you lie, or if you cheat, or if you steal, or if you don't honor your mom and your dad and make your bed like you're supposed to, you can go to the Savior and you can say, Jesus, I missed it. Jesus, you came to help me. Jesus, forgive me of that sin. And he's there to help you, to forgive you, because he's there to be your Savior. And it's only Jesus that can wash you squeaky clean. Say, squeaky clean. Have you ever been outside and you played and you made mud pies? Do y'all make mud pies? No. Y'all, y'all need to be born in the 80s, like I was. I spy books, mud pies. We played outside all day, out in the sun. Little Johnny was playing too many video games. He needed to get out in the sun and get some vitamin D. I lived on vitamin D when I was a kid, all right? But let's keep on finding God's love. Do you think we can find more of God's love in this book, this big book? You think so? Okay, do y'all got your magnifying glasses with me? All right, I'm gonna go to, this book called Romans. That sounds interesting. All right, Romans chapter 8. Oh, here we go. Verse 31, what shall we say about such wonderful things as these? If God is for us, who can be against me? What? That means if someone at school is bullying me, that means if God is on my team, if God is my Savior, if Jesus is my Lord, it doesn't matter? Because if I'm on team Jesus, that's all that matters? Yes. If God is for you, if God's love is abounding towards you, that is all you need, super kids. All you need, say, all I need, is to be on Team Jesus. Let's keep on reading. There's a lot to say in this book. This is a really good book. Do y'all like this book? I like this book. Since he did not spare even his own son, but God gave him up for us all, won't he also give us everything? Say everything.
Everything.
You can have everything. What if your mom came to you and said, what do you want for Christmas? And you said everything. They said done. Would you be excited?
Oh, yeah.
Like whatever you asked for, it was under the Christmas tree on Christmas morning. Someone said, oh my Lord. That's what Jesus does for you. It says he will give you everything. Everything you want and everything you need, because he's a good God. And then it says, who dares accuse us whom God has chosen for his own? No one, for God himself has given us right standing with God and himself. Who then will condemn us? No one. For Christ died for us and was raised to life for us, and he is seated in the place of honor at God's right hand, and he's pleading for us. In other words, no one can be against you. No one can be there to say you're guilty. No, because Jesus died on that cross. He was whipped. He was beaten. He was spit on. He was humiliated. But he took all that shame, all that sorrow, all that bitterness, everything you would ever, all that sadness, anything you would face in life, super kids, he took it on himself over 2,000 years ago. And that's where his love's at. Now, I'm going to keep on going. I'm going to look in the Old Testament. Have y'all ever read the Old Testament? It's kind of intense, okay? Do y'all think we can find God's love in the Old Testament?
Yes.
I mean, I see a lot of stuff in the Old Testament. I don't know if I can find his love. I don't know. It might be kind of hard, but okay, Psalms. Okay, Psalms 86. Okay. Oh, this is the guy named David. Do y'all know who David is? David is the guy who was after God's own heart. And this is what David said. Bend down, O Lord, and hear my prayer. Answer me, for I need your help. Let's go to verse 13. For your love for me is very great. Say, God loves me very much. Going over to verse 15. But you, O Lord, are a God of compassion and mercy, slow to get angry and filled, say filled, with unfailing love and faithfulness. So I want you to remember, Super Kids, this book is kind of like your life. There's a lot going on, a lot of friends, a lot of activities, maybe some sad times, and some really, really good times. But among everything you see in your life, the Bible says He has filled your life with His love. He has filled your life with His goodness and His unfailing love. So no matter how you feel, Super Kids, no matter what you're facing today, you can always find God's love on every page of your life. Amen? Now today, the first way to find God's love, to even let it be marked in your life, is you got to do something. You have to receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. So if you've never asked Jesus into your heart, you've never said, Jesus, I need help. I need forgiveness. I need a Savior. I'd like you to come up to this altar, and we're going to pray together for you to receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. So come on, if you want to receive Him, if you need help today, come on, give it up for Him. Come on. All right, it's okay. We'll wait. We'll wait. And maybe it was your first time praying with Johnny, and Johnny, he said that prayer of salvation. Maybe that was your first time. You want to come? He can come, Mama. He can come. Okay. So we're going to receive Jesus, and we're going to help our friends receive Jesus. Are y'all ready? Are y'all ready? Yes. Yes. All right. Hi, Carmine. High five. Hi, Riker. What's your name?
Ronan.
What is it?
Ronan.
Ronan. That's a sweet name. I like that. Okay. So are y'all ready to receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
He's going to be the best helper. And His love is going to become so big in your life and so evident. And sometimes you don't always feel it, but just know it's always there. His goodness will never leave you. His mercy, His kindness, even when you mess up, His love is going to be there to help you. Okay? Are you ready? All right. Ready! The Bible says to confess Him as your Lord and Savior, believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead. So do you believe that Jesus died?
Yes.
Do you believe He rose again? Do you believe that He's seated at the right hand of the Father?
Yes.
And that He is praying for you?
Yes.
And that He is helping you?
Yes.
Okay, you ready?
Ready?
All right, close your eyes. Let's say this. Say, Lord Jesus,
I receive
you as my Savior,
my helper,
my very best friend.
Forgive me, Lord,
of my mistakes.
Wash me
of all my sin. Today I will remember when you came into my life forever.
Help me every day
to look to you, to obey you, and to love you. In Jesus' name.
Amen!
Woo! Give it up! All right, Super Kids, you can go back to your seat. And Super Kids, are y'all ready for some fun?
Thank you for watching Super Kid Academy at Eagle Mountain International Church. Kids, with your parents' permission, visit us on Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. You can also visit us in person on Sunday mornings and Wednesday night services. We'll see you next time at Super Kid Academy.